And it's going to be a workshop with our laptop.
It's all good. Yeah, we'll send that to her next year.
But you can also stay when you like.
They don't want us talking because they're doing it.
So everyone was afraid about working without laptops.
I can ask them to announce this upstairs because, yeah, some people.
Okay, then we have three people.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Then we start. I will talk about design close events for developers, what we've learned. I'm Sandra, I'm from Wikimedia Deutschland EV, and what we did was in the last 2 years ago, 2014 and 15, trying out a lot of the events with developers to encourage people to open source software and also try to figure out which outreach events are good and how we can attract new people. And what is a little quick overview, we'll also put a presentation later on Fabricator about what things we did. So what we did is we did this year the experimenting and the testing with a podcast called Source Code Berlin, where we put developer topics on to get people listen to more. There's developing happening in Wikipedia or Wikimedia or just topics. Then we had a mentoring program for junior developers to get people invited to writing their PhD internships or volunteer to integrate them in our teams and provide working students or interns for them. That we also did was an Enthusiasticon. This is a bigger event where developers were invited to talk about their passionate topics or the topics they're passionate about and and share their ideas and share their hobbies. Then we had a free knowledge game jam, which was about to inviting the game developer community to work with free knowledge and use the Wikidata or open content to create games. This was a 2 days hackathon, and we also had last year the Ladies at Frost hackathon or the Ladies at Frost conference, where we invited a lot of women to join the open source community, and we did this together with a mentoring program from also other organizations like Mozilla or Nextcloud or Open Document Foundation to figuring out more people to join these events, which is today a regular meetup group, open source ladies meetup group. You can find it meetup.org, which is really awesome. And what we also did in these 2 years, we had deep focus interviews with seven developers, where we were interviewed them for 3 hours to talk about how did you get into your project, how did you learn coding, or how did you get into Wikimedia environment, how was it to set up everything, how did you keep yourself motivated over the long time, and also how they communicate in the projects and what they need, and what frustrates them, what makes them happy. And this was really valuable to create some model stories for have some role model developers for showing others this was my way into the project, maybe this could be also good. And then what we also did, that our developers overall went in 2016 and 2015 over 50 external developer events like JavaScript conferences or PHP conferences to talk about what they do to attract also people from conferences to our projects. And also this year we created a website, software.wikimedia.de, which is looking a little bit fancier than Wikitext too. Also show people what we did and also use this for recruiting and getting people into the projects. The lessons we learned of this, so you see all the links there. There you find all our reports, all our numbers. Because this is more workshop thing, I would introduce you, explain everything a little bit quickly, and when you want to go more deeper, let me know afterwards. The first thing we learned, and was really important for us, was that growth impact and popularity is attractive to people. On the one hand side, people like to work in projects or spend their volunteer time, which is maybe between 5 and 20 hours a week, for a project with 7 bigger impact. And Wikipedia is the top 5 website in the world, so people like this. What we also figured out was that in the whole open source software scene, Wikimedia is not that attractive, like working for Mozilla or developing Android and so on, because it's really complicated to get in and you have a lot of high barriers, and so you really have to convince people to start and really get them people on the hand to push them into the community. And other projects compared are a little bit easier to make the first step. Another big lesson we learned with creating the events was I am an individual, so every event you created, you really have to make some kind of user story beforehand to figuring out, or user journey to figuring out what is the target group, what kind of people I want to get into. For example, for the Ladies Sit Foss events, we also interviewed with some women before, or we talked about geekheads or other women networks, figuring out what is important for these events. We figured out that, for example, writing some policies for event has to be really focused on the target group. Then we also, for the game developer or game jam we did, important for us was to work with museums together or game science centers, who's providing us with virtual reality glasses or other things people can play with, because this is really important in game industry. That they can prototype games and that they can explore stuff. And the other thing which has really come to us was a clear communication to lower the entry barriers. With all the developers we talk to and with all the developers we meet on events or we interviewed, which are also a little bit longer in the movement, we got the get a message here that no one was able to go or actually Wikimedia alone for themselves. So everyone needed someone else to get mentored or continuously contact our IRC and so on, and to make it for them easier. And this is not really the fastest way for getting people into the projects. So one of our big goals for last year and this year is already to improve the documentation where we can. And the first thing is that all people overrated that freedom and welcome culture is the main motivator for everyone to be here. So everyone we talked to and everyone who joined our events and then joined, for example, hackathons or get deeper in contact with people, were really happy that we're really friendly, that people can talk to us, that we're writing back, that we're making code reviews, and that there are possibilities to that you have the freedom to do stuff after you learn everything, and you learn also to set up Wikibase and other hard things. It's really overrated good that you have the freedom to choose your own projects, because it's really, really important when you invest your volunteer time in it and not get focused on you have to do this task, and this task. Okay, and the fifth one is that we also figured out that the offline engagement is good to get in a project, but the online engagement makes me stay. So providing hackathons and events is nice to get people in contact to each other. It's also nice to get people showing the project or showing people how to get into a project. But what makes people stay is continuously communication via online tools, continuously networks, they're having their people they can meet later on, and so on. Okay, so these are the five topics wise we learned so far, and how we did this, and we did this with a nice method we also do in our software development and engineering department, and this is design thinking. Did someone ever heard about this? Yep. Good. Okay, so design thinking is a human-centered approach to innovate that draws from designers' toolkit to integrate the needs of people, the possibilities of technology, and the requirements for project success. So it's in some innovation method you can use to develop solutions, to think about problems and develop effective solutions so that you can prototype something and you can test it and you have really good data results, and then you can figure out which is the best action item I can, or which is the best solution for solving the problem. And it's a really nice way to do. And behind this one, this is also mindset. I quickly wrote down, important here is that every time that you go through this whole design thinking process, it's a process I also introduce you to, you have to think about that you're a beginner of things, that you have just fresh, not influenced from all the past and things you've ever done. Mindset that you always keep what a person who first is trying out a service or product. Mindset. Then you should focus on human values, so what is important for the people are providing it for. Then you should embrace experimentation, so it's really important to be open to everything and not block ideas or block experimentation things. Then be mindful of the process. Try to radical collaborate. What we figured out is that when we make a woman hackathon, we not have to do it with our project alone. We can ask other project to have similar project, have similar problems, and put mentors together and find better solutions together than alone. This is really important. Then don't be afraid to fail. When some events doesn't went really well, then it's okay. You tried it out and know it later. So for example, Tim's Enthusiasticon was really interesting. We had a lot, we got a lot of nice talks from developers, and we also recorded them and could use the content afterwards. But to get people in the project, it was not a right event construction, because people more did it for their self social media marketing than getting really in the project. So then think of the corner cases, but don't obsess with details, so that you also think in the corner cases what's there, and be ready to kill your babies. So this is also a thing you've learned, and you always want to do a hackathon or game jam, and you really start with the idea. Sometimes maybe it's also not the right thing, and you have to say to your best idea you have or to the thing you really want to do goodbye, because it's not what the target group wants or what the people want you building it for. So yes, the process we are talking about is this one. This is also the thing we try out now. You have the first part, always the first part, the research part, where you're trying to understand the needs of the user. So you're trying to understand the needs of the developer you're designing an event for. Then you observe the people, you engage the people, and you're listening to asking why you have a problem with that, why you maybe not have a problem to get into, to set up Wikibase, or why you have a problem to work with me and Wiki, or why you found us not really attractive as a open source project. And then you ask to try to understand it. Then from all the answers you get and from all the information, you build up a synthesis. This is a define process step. You define a problem statement and ask yourself, how might we? And then you put a problem on it, and this is your main question for the whole process. In the ADIET process, it's a wide brainstorming process where you sketch building on other ideas, where you have producing first ideas and have a big brainstorming part without blocking, without guessing, to be open. And then you have a prototype part where you really go more deeper in your prototyping of your idea. You try to create some kind of concept, how you can make it real. And then you get feedback on it from other people. You iterate with the feedback you got. You capture the feelings from the people. And you, for example, building a product, people can touch it, people can feel it, and then you see, okay, how they use it. When you're creating a service or an event, you can introduce this to people and you see the reactions. And then you go to test it. And in the end, you execute it. So when you found a good idea, then it's really important to always stay open, collaborate with other people, get people involved, and also be agile with it. So trying to make it flexible as possible for you and your attendees. Okay, it's getting cold in the room. Good, and that was basically all what I wanted. wanted to sum up about the things we did at Wikimedia and why I chose the topic, and I think it's a nice topic to work on. And now it's your turn, because now I want you, because I prepared worksheets, I want you that here do one whole design thinking process. Mm-hmm. And for this, it would be super great when you pair up in teams. Mm-hmm. So we need can do two teams of two people. And what I already did is giving you a problem situation, or a problem that you can solve. So I did the first two steps to make the time much more faster. So how might we appreciate volunteer developers in Wikimedia projects to keep the fire burning also after events? I think it's a big challenge everyone has. And for this, when you go prepares, everyone gets a worksheet, and then we will go through the worksheet. So I always give for every page a single introduction, and then I have also a timer because every task we have to do is 4 minutes. And then we work on it, and in the end we present all the results. So it's super great. You can also sit in the front when you find a pair and sit together somewhere else, have pens or post-its, whatever you want.
Maybe one thing today.
Yeah, because he's doing